is Kayla, and I am back with another freaking video. So, as you guys can see by the title and thumbnail, I'm going to be doing an at-home maintenance with you guys. I'm very realistic when it comes to saving money and just, like, still trying to be that girl while on a budget. If you don't know, I'm 20 and I'm a mom. So, doing things at home and learning how to, like, do my own maintenance really helps out because at the end of the day, baby, them $40 that I was going to spend on my toes to get done, I gotta start spending that on some diapers. So this is very realistic. I hope you guys enjoy. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, turn your post notifications on. We're on a roll to 2K and let's jump right into the video. I feel like I'm dressed for the occasion. My little cute black robe, and yeah, just it's giving spa day, it's giving maintenance. Super duper excited. So y'all, these braids are from my previous wig install. You guys know I'm inspiring to be a wig influencer, so like I've been trying to do my own wigs and stuff like that. I gotta get this excess glue off my hair. It's not really a lot, but it is a little bit there, so we gotta get that off. I don't know, I'm about to just use my towel right here and then the 70% alcohol. And I'm gonna go to like the corner of the towel and just drench it in alcohol. Like, you need a lot. Alcohol has been the only thing that I've known to get the glue off my wigs, even before I was doing my own wigs and I was getting them installed. I don't know, I just feel like alcohol is the only thing that really works to get it off. Well, I know they made glue remover, but I haven't tried that, so I can't really like speak on that and say like if that works or not. But yeah, it takes a good like 5-10 minutes just to get it off, but sometimes it'd be burning my eyes. I don't know, I think it's because it's so strong, but that's definitely something that happens a lot. I'm not even gonna lie to you. I think it's like the fumes from the alcohol, if that makes sense. I hope I make sense in what I'm saying. Do y'all see that? I still got my edges and the glue is off. That's definitely, I would say, a pro to doing your own hair and doing your own maintenance. You can do everything how you want it and just keep on doing it until it comes out right. A long time ago, I picked up this shower headband from Dollar Tree. And we're gonna finally use it today. I actually got the little wristlet things too. I'm gonna put those on also, and we're about to just go ahead and jump right into our skincare slash facial little treatment thing. These are the wristlets. They also came from Dollar Tree, so they were both $1.25. The alcohol was like 97 cents from the store, I think. So yeah, look how cute. Oh, this is so cute. I actually feel like an it girl. Hoes hate me because I'm an it girl. Don't call me sis because I'm not your sister. I know a lot of people get facials. I'm not really sure in the purpose of a facial, to be honest with you. I've never gotten a facial and I don't really think I'll ever plan on getting one unless like I do research and figure out like the what's the pros about it and like what's so good about getting one. Because I feel like you can just wash your face every day, clean it, everything like that, and you should be straight. Like me, I wash my face daily and everything like that, and I never get like blackheads or anything like that. I'll get a few bumps when it's close to like that time of the month, but other than that, I never get bumps. I use Dove Sensitive Skin Scope, a little cheap brush from Dollar Tree, and I just take care of my skin every day by washing my face every night or every morning. It depends, but I will say I wash my face at least once a freaking day. And my skin normally looks clear and pretty good. So yeah, that's that. One thing I will say that I feel like a lot of people don't do is clean their face brush or their bath cloth after they're done washing their face, which is most likely why their skin continues to break out. Because you have to think about it. This is removing the dirt. So keeping the dirt on there, that makes no sense to me. I don't know if this is old school, but me personally, I stick to like just regular soap, water, and moisturizer. I don't do all that extra ice rolling, face mask, all that stuff. I feel like when you start adding all the extra, implementing all the extra shit to your routines, it just makes everything more complicated because then you can't figure out what's breaking out your face, what's really good for your face, what's really not, all that type of stuff. This is the moisturizer that I use, which is some Black Girl sunscreen. I go in with this sunscreen, which everybody's supposed to be using an SPF anyway. So yeah, I go in with this sunscreen and I use it just like I would use any other face moisturizer. Before this, before my pediatrician prescribed this to me, I was just simply using Pond's or Cetaphil, but ever since I started using this, I fell in love with it. It really moisturized my face and just keeps it like at a nice complexion and makes sure everything is evenly toned out, which is something that I really do truly love. So yeah, done with the face. You know, everything got a clean little base. Everything is always needed to be a clean base. I'm going to take my little wristlets off. And now we're going to get into shaving. I do wax, but I wax only occasionally. I don't know how to really, I'll go through it where, I'm waxing for, 4 months straight or 5 months straight. Then all of a sudden, I just go back to shaving. And honestly, the pain of waxing, I don't think I could bear to do that by myself. So I'm going to shave. I got these Bic razors, which are from Dollar Tree, along with some Pure Silk shaving cream, which is also from Dollar Tree. I'm going to shave my armpits, and I'm also going to shave my legs. I could blame it on your lips, your touch, your kiss, you know, real traditional. But your love's too original. You were anything but conventional. Baby, did you know we fell from the moment we fell in and knew we couldn't fall back? Knew I'd always crawl back. All right, it's time to start my hair, you guys. I am going to be installing this $60 wig that I got from the hair store. Well, it was $60, but then I think it was 20% off. Yeah, it was 20% off, so however much that is. Yeah, it's just a regular bob. I don't know how to bleach knots or anything like that, so I got some regular even tinted lace, which is this little pencil thing, which is supposed to tint the lace. I got mine in the color medium dark brown. We're gonna see how this works as far as tinting the lace, because like I told you guys, I don't know how to bleach knots or anything like that. I'm already in my braid down. I don't have a really a braid down tutorial or anything like that, and I'm really honestly not gonna take these out and redo them. All I'm gonna do is use a ponytail holder and then just literally put these braids back in a ponytail, just so that way I can have the flat look. I also don't really do the bald cap method, if I'm being honest with you guys. I always use a wig cap, but never using the got to be spray and making it flat and all that stuff. I feel like people get too fixated on certain things while they're doing their installs, which is why your install process is so long and also so hard, if that also makes sense. Don't mind my daughter. Everybody knows I have a baby. It's obviously Kayla in Essence World all the time, right? High five. Yeah. Mom's thirsty. You're thirsty here. Don't waste it. Okay. That's enough. Okay, so I'm still a beginner when it comes to wigs and everything like that. So I can just give everybody the best advice that I give myself, if I'm being realistic. I don't know. I'm not a professional to tell you guys, I'm not arrogant tearing that to tell you guys, this is what you need to do and all that stuff. I'm not E. Kane. But what I will tell you is you have to put the wig, on with the clips and everything so you can see where to add your glue. That's a must. You can't just, put your glue wherever, because if not, if you do that, you're going to literally have white spots everywhere. And I recommend having a lot of mirrors, y'all. I got my vanity mirror. I have this small, tiny mirror. I'll be using my iPad sometimes. You need mirrors so you can look at your wig in every single angle just to make sure everything is gonna fit and look correct. That's currently what I'm doing. I'm trying to get it as close to my hairline, but low-key far so I don't glue it as possible, which would be about right here. So once you have that mapped out, I'm gonna go in with a pencil, which is going to be a regular eyebrow pencil, and just lightly line the outline of where I need to put the glue, which is basically lining around the lace. This really, really light pencil. I don't know if y'all can see the line, but it's very light, because if not, once you lay that lace down, you're going to be able to see it if you use a black pencil. Y'all see the line, how light it is? If you guys want to pick one of these up, it's a brow pencil by LA Colors, and it's in the color dark blonde, which it works really, really good. And you literally can't barely tell that I'm using a pencil. All it really looks like, to be quite honest, ash. You see how it looks? Which is really good. So that way, after the glue goes on and everything like that, it won't be visible through the lace, because your lace should be so clear that it's melting. You get what I mean? So once I have my line, I go ahead and pull my wig back and just apply the glue. This is the glue that I'm going to be using, which is the Mia glue, and it was $3.99 at my local beauty supply store. And I just follow the line that I already have drawn there with the pencil. Literally just follow it. And I follow it three times. So I do my first coat, how I'm showing you guys. And then I go for a second time and then go for a third time. Make sure that you get the side of your hair right here too, because you want those ear flaps to actually lay down and not. Those are always the first thing to come up. So I have a tendency to put a lot more glue right there just because, like, bruh, I hate when that comes up. That makes me feel like I need to take the whole wig off and give myself a whole new wig install. Now, I want everybody to remember that everybody has their own way of doing everything, their own techniques. A lot of people use like a fine tooth comb and go ahead and spread the glue out and then use a blow dryer and let it dry clear like that. Me personally, I let mine air dry and I don't spread it out. I just leave it like so, just because I do mine directly on the line, so I know that's enough space for my wig. But everybody has their own preference, like I said, and ways of doing things. Next up, we're going to start on my lashes while I wait for this to dry. Now, my lashes, I can move pretty fast with them because, like, I've done it multiple times. But on my first few tries, I would say it took me, like, about an hour and 30. So, these are my Amazing Girl lashes, which I will link down in my description box. I'm going to have everything linked down in my description box, from the lace glue that I'm using, the eyelash glue. All my products that I'm going to be using in this video will be linked down below in my Amazon storefront, so that way you guys can purchase them and go ahead and do your own maintenance. And if you do, make sure you tag me, like, on Instagram, wherever, so I can see. So yeah, these are the lashes. It comes with the numbers 9 all the way to 16, and it comes with two rolls of it. It's 320 lashes in here. And then it also comes with the lash bond seal and bond and lash remover. But I stopped using this and I just started using the Super Stronghold 3D Lash Clear by the Eye Envy, the magenta one. I started using this when I do my lashes just because it makes them last way longer than the bond and seal. But to each his own, you can use whatever you want to do. I'm going to show you guys how I do this. I'm going to show you guys like a few of them. I got my mirror, of course, so I can get up close and really personal. And I like to turn mine to like the 3x magnifying, just so like I can see very, very, very like up close on my eye. I choose the number that I want. I always put it on the tweezers like this. And then I take my glue and I place my glue along the lash band. It's like very, very simple, very light. And I just apply it along the lash band and go ahead and stick it. Well, I hold my eye up like this and then I just stick it on there, y'all. Alright guys, these are my lashes and I went ahead and applied another layer of my glue. My lash map will be on the screen, but I'll also go ahead and say it for you guys. I did 9, 10, and 1, 11 on the end. So it's like, I believe it's 4, it's 1, 11 on both sides, and then it's 4 10s and then like 3 9s. And yeah, I love my lashes. I love going for natural looks when I'm not really going to like a big event or popping out, to be honest with you. Like when I'm just on my regular day-to-day shit, I love like natural lashes. But like if I was getting ready for my birthday or something like that, then I would have definitely went like bigger and bolder for my minks. But that's that. So now we're gonna move on to my eyebrows. Now this is probably gonna sound crazy, and I know a lot of people are not gonna believe this, but I am 20 years old, y'all, and I've never gotten my eyebrows done. Like, never gotten them done. Never got them tweezed. Never got them arched. Never got them tinted. None of that before. My mom never let me. And then once my senior year came, I never went, like, chose to go by myself. And I don't know. I never got them done. But I do clean them up and touch them up myself. So I'm going to show you guys how I do it. And I recently just started doing this, like, about over a year ago. But before that, I was letting my eyebrows just be how they are. Now, I don't know why I still haven't went and got them done. I don't know why I'm holding on to like not getting them. Like at this point, my mom has let my little sisters, mind you, I'm the oldest, she's let my little siblings get their lashes done and everything. I mean, get their lashes done, their nails done, their eyebrows done. But when me and my twin were growing up, she didn't let us do that type of stuff. And I don't know, I just haven't felt the urge, just, I guess I can kind of say, like, to go do it, or like a rush to do it. I'm like, whenever I feel like going to get my lashes and stuff done, I guess that's when I'll do it, basically. 99-cent eyebrow pencil right from the hair store. It was literally at the cash register when you check out. I live by these. This is also what people use when they're cutting their lace. It's just like this little razor, like, so I'm pretty sure everybody has seen this type. And then I have a brown pencil, which is an eyeliner and lip pencil by Color Studio, and it's in the color dark brown. And then a regular spoolie that I got from one of my previous lash sets that I did or got done. All I do is brush my eyebrows and go ahead and shape them in the shape that I want them to be. So I really don't have a natural arc, so I always make my arc, and I always make my arc with the Spoolie Fresh. Like, this is just basically like the outline. I always do this even when I'm filling in my eyebrows. I brush them up and just like shape them and get them, you know, in the look that I want them to go for, which is always just my look for my eyebrows is always just like zoop zoop. So basically, like, I like my eyebrows to look like this, like a triangle, like the top of a triangle basically, but with like a little curve. Like, I don't like the arc of my eyebrow to be like so pointy, but I do like having like an arc like that. I don't know, that's just my preference, that's just something that I like to do. I don't know. I'm gonna zoom in so you guys can actually see like my eyebrows and how they look, and you guys can understand what I'm saying as we move on to the razor process. So as you guys can see, my eyebrows are done in the shape that I like them, going up like this and down as I said, and you can see like those little hairs down at the bottom right here. So I literally just take my razor and I just glide the razor right under there and get to removing those hairs from the bottom like so. So once I'm done with the bottom, I go ahead and do the top, which I don't know if you guys can tell, but it's like three or four little pieces of hair right there that need to go ahead and get razored off the same way, except this time I use my razor at like an angle like this rather than using it like this when I was doing the bottom. So I just use it going up like so. Are done and cleaned up how I like them. Sometimes I decide to go ahead and line them with the pencil, but I'm not doing that right now just simply because I'm really not going anywhere and I don't feel the need to line them. I feel like they look so good and just cleaned up and just really nicely arced, and like, you know, they just give that vibe of my eyebrows being done, which is something that I love and like. We're now gonna go ahead and jump back, not the Roku remote in my wig, child. We're gonna now go ahead and jump back into doing my hair. Now, I don't know if you guys are familiar with wigs, but all wigs come with like this little flap in the back. You gotta cut this off. It's no point in having it, it's no sense in having it. Just go ahead and chop it off, honestly. I'm not gonna talk, I'm just gonna go ahead and do it because this is not a wig tutorial. I'm not a wig like guru just yet to give like a tutorial step by step. All I can tell you is just, you know, braid your hair back, apply your glue, let your glue dry clear, then apply your wig and match your lace up with your glue, and then put the band on and band for an hour, and then come back and straighten your hair and style it how you want. That's really all I could tell you. Like, I can't give you steps on how to do it because I'm still learning myself. So yeah, I don't put your love so original. You were anything but original. Baby, did you know that from the moment we fell in and knew we couldn't fall back? My hair is done. I'm putting my band on for an hour like I'm supposed to, and while we wait the hour, I'm gonna go ahead and start with my nails, which is my favorite part. If you guys do not know, I took a whole lash class. I also took lash class and nail class and got certified in both, and I just never like pursued it, so I'm pretty good with like nails and stuff like that. I get my nails from Dollar Tree or Shein. The most I ever spend on my press-on nails is like $2, I'm not gonna lie. So these that I'm going to apply today are from Dollar Tree. You have to make sure that you get two packs of nails when you do shop at Dollar Tree. You can use one pack for Shein, but Dollar Tree you need two because it only comes with 12, and it literally comes with one size of each nail. So like, you know how I don't know if you guys ever use press-ons, but it starts from number 0 and then it goes so forth like that all the way up to number 12. So you literally have one number, so that means you literally have different size nails on both hands when you're supposed to have, you know, this, if you use a 7 for the pinky, you're supposed to use a 7 for the other pinky. You get what I'm trying to say? So you need two packs, so you basically get a whole like entire nail set for literally $2.50. The glue is included in the nails, but I like to use this other glue because I like my nails to stay on for about a month to like maybe 3 weeks. And with the glue that comes in the boxes of nails, it always lasts only about 2 weeks for me, and that's really not long enough. I don't like to do maintenance like
very, very often, probably once a month. So that's why I stick to this other glue. Glue is pretty expensive, but it lasts a while and it's definitely worth the money to me. Like I told you guys, sometimes I have to literally soak my press-ons off after like a whole month to get them off. This is the glue. It's called Beauty Secrets Nail Glue, which I get from Sally Beauty. This is how it looks. I don't know if you guys know about this glue, but this glue is like literally going viral all on TikTok. I'm trying to get the camera to focus so you guys can see, but yeah, this is it. And I'm still on my first, well, not my first, but my same bottle of glue way back from when I did my back to school prep, everything like that. So that's really crazy. This is a pair of nails that I got from Shein, just in case you guys want to see like how the Shein nails look. And like I said, you only need one box of Shein nails. Shein nails come with 24 nails in the box, which means they give you two of each one. So yeah, I'm definitely like a nail girly. If I show you guys this nail drawer, it's full of like a nail drill. I have everything, literally. Like, anyway, we're gonna start this nail process. It's very simple with how to do press-on nails. It's really self-explanatory, to be quite honest with you guys. I love press-on nails. I live by press-on nails. I'm a big fan of press-on nails. 10 out of 10, I would definitely recommend. I'm so happy that I'm going with like this like black French tip type of look. And yeah, the first step that I always do, this is still kind of hot, I don't even know where I'm gonna put it. I'm trying to move it over here. The first step that I do when I do my nails is always just get my numbers out. By now, I've been doing it for so long that I literally remember all my numbers to my nails. So like, this process literally takes me no freaking time at all. The whole nail process really doesn't take me that long, to be quite honest. So I'm about to match my nails up really quick. It's now time for like the nail care of my actual real nails. So this is when I would cut them, file them, buff them, and then go ahead and pull my cuticles back. My real nail is prepped. I prep the press-on nail, and I do it one by one. Like, if I'm working on the thumb, then I prep the thumb one. I don't just do them all at one time. I don't know. That's just, like, my flow. So all I do is use the same file, and I literally just file the inside of the nail, making the press-on nail also a sticky and tacky base for when it's time to apply the glue. And when I'm filing, I file the inside, and I also file around the corners, getting that perfect shape that I want, and also removing the little press-on tip. So I just file it all around and just do this process to each nail every time I'm about to apply one. All right, y'all, so nails are done, and it's been about an hour and 45 minutes since I did my hair, so I'm ready to take it off and like see it myself and show you guys at the same time. Let's go ahead and comb it down though, because it's like a little stiff, but my bob, it's fine. Yeah, it's giving scalp. I ate this up. Another perfect luscious install, if I do say so myself. If I do say so myself. Yes, ma'am. The bob is bobbing. The bob is really cute. I'm loving my bob, y'all. I'm definitely feeling it. I definitely might have to run the flat iron through it one more time though, simply because I have the elastic band, so it's like got a little dent in it or whatever. But the cut that I did on it, I ate that up. Everything about it, like, look at the lace wear. Like, are y'all seeing me? Are y'all fucking with me? No. But are y'all seeing me? Hell yes. And then my nails, this is how they came out, you guys. Like, look at my freaking nails. Yes, I'm a little ashy, disregard that, but the nails, like, what? Lashes. Like, get into everything. Like, everything just eats down to me. Like, I literally started this video off looking like a, to now looking like that fine mommy Yana. Okay, clock it. I'm really feeling it. I'm loving the look. I'm here for it.